to the afternoon lineup for this Wednesday, January 25th, 2023. I am Larry Hawley here on WGN News Now, as we tell you what's happened, what's happening, and what's going to happen in the world of Chicago sports today and tonight. On this edition of the show, we'll first feature some news from NASCAR, a little unusual here in the Windy City for late January, but some important information came out about the Chicago Street Race. Those are the concerts which have been set for July 1st and July 2nd. The Chainsmokers will be the main event on Saturday night after the Xfinity race, with Miranda Lambert headlining the Cup Race Day show on Sunday. The Black Crows will play before the Xfinity race on Saturday, with Charlie Crockett opening for Lambert on Sunday. Two-day general admission tickets for this event will also go on sale the morning of February 2nd. That was announced on Wednesday. They'll start at $269. You can see more information on the information that came out today on WGNTV.com. The Bulls' three-game winning streak is history after a bad second half against the Pacers in Indianapolis last night. Up 21 points in the first half and then 8 in the fourth quarter, the Bulls fumbled away the contest in a 116-110 loss to Indiana that drops them to 22-25 on the season. DeMar DeRozan had 33 points, including 11 in the fourth quarter, but Zach LaVine was scoreless in that frame as the Bulls were outscored 36-23 in the final 12 minutes. The team is now going to Charlotte, where they will face the Hornets on Wednesday evening. The Blackhawks score from last night against Vancouver might seem a little surprising, not because they lost 5-2, but the fact that they got two goals at all. They had quite a poor offensive performance, for they only had 14 shots on goal over 60 minutes. Yet Patrick Kane and Sam Lafferty were able to score in the first and second period, but Vancouver took over after that, scoring the final four goals of the game to come out with that 5-2 decision. The Hawks will face the Flames in Calgary on Thursday. Illinois got back on the winning track against Ohio State last night, beating the Buckeyes 69-60 in Champaign, with that man, Chicago native Terrence Shannon Jr., leading the way with 17 points. The Illini are now 5-4 in the Big Ten. DePaul lost to Georgetown last night as well. Meanwhile, Northwestern is looking to go for two in a row in the Big Ten and go two games over the 500 mark in the conference against Nebraska in Lincoln at 6 p.m. They beat Wisconsin in Evanston on Monday in a COVID makeup game. Loyola has an Atlantic 10 game against Duquesne also at 6 p.m. as the Ramblers look to get on track in the conference. They have struggled mightily so far. Cubs fans and White Sox fans are patiently awaiting the snow to go away and get back to watching baseball. Spring training is close, but there's still a few months until the games are played on the north and south sides. But you can start planning your trip to the ballpark now. Both teams have now announced and their single-game tickets are going on sale. The White Sox are first on February 2nd at 2 p.m., and you can go to their website to buy all those contests at that time at Guaranteed Rate Field. The Cubs are next a few weeks later, selling their single-game tickets at 10 a.m. on Friday, February 24th. The season ticket holder pre-sale for the Cubs will be 2 days before, on February 22nd. This week's Random Hawlight features someone very special to so many in Chicago's radio and media landscape. Lin Brehmer died at the age of 68 after a battle with prostate cancer on Sunday. The legendary host at 93 WXRT was known for his personality both on and off the air, along with a few poetic tributes he had through the years, especially to the Chicago Cubs, a few that aired right here on WGN-TV. This week on The Hawlight, we feature a very special one that we had right here on Channel 9.
And now it's time to say farewell. The end of a baseball story that embraces generations, from grandfathers to grandchildren and beyond. For most of 70 years, when you said you'd be watching the Cubs, there was no need to search the TV guide. You watched them on WGN-TV. You watched them on spring days when you came home from a rough day at school, and there they were, your sun-splashed, hard-luck heroes running around a ballpark from a bygone era.
That was Lin's tribute before the final Chicago Cubs game ever to air on WGN on September 27, 2019. It was one of a number he did to pay tribute to the end of contests for the club being aired on Channel 9. All of Brehmer's tributes left a lasting impression on those who watched and will continue to do so after his death. You can read more about the late host on WGNTV.com. That will wrap it up for this edition of the Afternoon Lineup here on WGN News Now for January 25th of 2023. For up-to-the-date sports news, log on to WGNTV.com. But for now, I'm Larry Hawley, and have a wonderful day.